Hello all. So let's continue with the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as we have just generated an output from this, I'll definitely show you the output of it. So I have generated a test render over here for this. That's your test render which I have generated. So as you can see over here, we have created a volume also over here. I have not generated the passes yet over here, but we can definitely generate those passes over here. So how you can set up the passes, it's very simple over here. Let's go into rendering, render setup. So once you go into the render setup over here, you can just go into the render elements and you can activate those passes by adding those light passes over here by clicking on the add button over here. So you can add V-Ray atmosphere, V-Ray diffuse filter, V-Ray global illumination, V-Ray illuminance, V-Ray lighting, V-Ray reflection, V-Ray shadows, V-Ray specular and V-Ray Z-depth. So these are the passes which I have definitely, you know, set as active over here. So now what you can do is, like, you can just get back into the camera view over here, press shift and F, that's a show save frames, and after that, if you want the render to be much more faster, I can just reduce the settings of the renderer over here. So let me save the file first and let's just reduce the settings of the renderer as the maximum. I'll keep it as 2 over here right now. Color mapping is okay. Let's go into GI. That's perfect. I'll make it as very low over here. So make sure while you're working over here, you know, by keeping the full settings with a maximum subdivisions might take a very long time. So as almost as you can see over here, it almost took 2 to 3 hours to render one frame. So you can just reduce its subdivisions to 500 over here. After that, what I can do over here is I can again go back to this V-Ray panel over here. I'll go into this and your minimum samples which are set as 32 over here, I'll set it as 16 over here, and noise 0.015. so 0.005. so it's like if you reduce the settings, the render quality will definitely deviate over here. So you need to take care. The image filter, we're keeping it as it is, so we're not changing those settings for now at least. So into the GI option, that's your global illumination, your primary engine, that's your iridescent map, and your secondary engine, that's your light cache. Your subdivisions, let's set the subdivisions. I'll set the subdivisions to 50 and 20 over here. So this are all your you know, for reducing the render time. Okay, that's more important. And once you're done over here, let's just check out the things. So your minimum sample rate, minimum rate is 1 and maximum I've kept it as 2 over here. And your color mapping, as usual, I have set it to exponential over here. So make sure you keep the settings accordingly, or else it will take a very long time according to your configuration of your machine and your graphics card. So let's render it and let's see how much time it takes for rendering this. So I've reduced all the settings, and also very very important is, like, you reduce the samples into the material. So as you have set the samples in the previous tutorial, as you have seen, we have kept the samples as 16 over there. You can just reduce it to 8. So definitely that will reduce the render time. Now you can see the render time has been reduced as I have reduced the subdivisions and the settings over here. So I need to reduce the subdivisions for the materials also to reduce the, you know, quality of and render time also, to decrease the render time. So let's render it again. So I reduce the materials to subdivisions to 8 instead of 16. And now let's render it again. So the most important part over here is like to reduce the render time. So now the subdivisions for all the materials are 8 instead of 16. And definitely you will see a bit of noise over here as we have reduced the subdivisions, but your render time will reduce. So if you are generating a final renderer, then you can just increase the, all the settings, like increasing the subdivisions and all. So now let's see. So now let's see how long does it take to render this. Still it's taking time. speaking a long time. Let's see. So it's rendering the image. So what we'll do is just, we'll just wait for a while, let it render. So as you can see, we have just the rendered this kitchen over here. So as you can see, with this, all these passes, definitely I have just removed the V-Ray fog over here because it was taking a longer time to render. But as you can see over here, we have generated all this different passes over here, which are required over here for the output over here. So now let's save this passes and let's just composite this passes. So very first of all, I'll go first with the diffuse filter, and I'll make a new folder. That's your passes kitchen, and the first pass is your diffuse pass. Save it as JPG. Your global illumination pass, that's your GI. We also need to generate an occlusion pass, so GI JPG, illuminance. Okay, let's save this JPG. So you need to save all these passes one by one. Now that's your lighting pass over here. So let's save it as lighting over here, your reflection pass. So all these different passes are beneficial while compositing it. Refraction. So let's save this. Shadow. Specular. And your Z depth, which helps for the depth over here. So after you have generated all these passes, I'll just close this stuff. Let me save as this file over here. I'll just save as this over here. And let's go into the material over here. And let's take a V-Ray dirt material. So we need a dirt material over here. Let's take a V-Ray dirt material. Before that, we take this dirt material over here. We need a V-Ray light material. Into the light material, you can just take this as V-Ray dirt over here. So let's just delete this. Let's go into this and increase its radius to 300 and let's assign it. So let's just render it. So now before you start rendering it, it's more important that you delete all this passes, go into this V-Ray, and that's your override material, and let's render it. That would be your occlusion over here. Till then it renders. Let's open Photoshop over here. Let's take Photoshop, open application. So let's open those passes over here. the light passes which we have just saved over here. Let's open those passes. Delete the lights if you want. So once you're done, just save the file over here. Save this as occlusion. Let's go onto the desktop. Your passes. Save it in JPG over here. Just save your file over here. Now, let's go into Photoshop and again let's go into the passes folder and let's open all these passes. So very first of all, the first pass which we'll be taking, that's your diffuse pass. So that's your diffuse over here. On the diffuse we'll be utilizing reflection pass. So let's take this reflection pass and just drop it over here and let's use a screen over here. As you can see this, so that's a reflection pass. Then you have a refraction pass. So refraction is beneficial, that's for the glass objects. And let's again give a refraction, that's a refraction over here. Your lighting pass, so take this, put it on top of it and again use this. Can use a screen also. GI, let's use this GI, global illumination. So for that we can use any of the passes. Oh, sorry, the blending mode, sorry, we can use the blending mode. This is much better. Your occlusion pass which is just left out, we need to put this occlusion pass after the diffuse over here. So occlusion is definitely going to give you a bit of depth. So for the better depth, I think this looks much perfect over here in the darker color. Or you can just change it. Let's go with other stuff. This also looks good. Hard light, soft light, or darker color. Or hard light. This looks better. So now your specular pass, you need a specular also on top of it. The shine, that's your hard light. Specular pass, we need a specular pass. So let's open this specular pass again over here. First let's unlock this layer and push it top of it and let's use this. That That's your specular. Can you see the shine? That's your specular. So I think this looks good over here. That's your thick screen is okay. After that we have one more pass. That's your Z depth. That's for the depth over here. So let's use this pass again on top of it. That's for your Z depth. That's for the depth. So as you can see the depth. That's your Z depth pass. So Z depth is beneficial if you want to generate some depth. This looks good. Better. Sinus. That's for the depth. And again one pass for the shadow. That's for the darker areas. Looks more flat. Alright. I think this looks good. That's your soft shadows. So if you see all these passes, you can see the things getting changed. So you can just color correct a bit if you want. You can just go over here and you can just use some color balance. Color correct this stuff as you like. So let's again go over here and use some photo filter. Alright. So that's how you generate. So thanks for watching this tutorial.